Hi y'all, I'm Jody Wolfborn, a curriculum developer at Chef Software, and this set of videos is designed to accelerate your understanding and usage of InSpec, a testing and compliance automation framework. In this first video, I'll introduce you to InSpec and explain how its built-in capabilities and integrations allow you to start utilizing test-driven development and eliminate weeks of rework during audit cycles. I'll also help set the stage for the next videos in this series, which will help you get hands-on using the different components of InSpec. And you can also visit the docs at inspec.io/docs to get more in-depth information about the different components. So, what exactly is InSpec? I'm glad I asked. InSpec is Chef's open source language for describing security and compliance rules or policies that can be shared between software, operations, and security engineers. Your compliance, security, and other policy requirements become automated tests that can then be run against traditional servers, containers, and cloud APIs alike, ensuring consistent standards are enforced in every environment that you manage and at every stage of development. And because InSpec is easy to learn and human readable by design, it can be used across teams to gain a unified understanding of your organizational compliance. That's a bit of marketing speak to say everyone, devs, sysadmins, SecOps, and IT managers can use the same easy to understand language to describe and test for system vulnerabilities and risks in pre and post-production. Historically, compliance and security have been afterthoughts to the development and operations of a system or environment. In this diagram, we see the typical treatment of testing and security, where the development and operations teams do their things, and then before sending everything to production, it all gets tested in a big batch. If there are any issues, everything goes back to stage one of the process and then waits until that last step before production to be tested again. It's a process that works until it doesn't, and it definitely breaks down when zero-day vulnerabilities are announced. How are you going to identify which systems in your fleet are vulnerable? Once you have a remediation, how are you going to verify that it actually patches the vulnerability or that nothing the developers do will overwrite the change? With InSpec, we've described our policies using code, which means we can use them again and again, customize them, or modify them whenever we need to. The InSpec toolset then allows us to scan systems in pre-prod environments the same way we scan our production systems, so that no change ever makes it to production without complying with our regulatory, organizational, and team policies first. The next videos in this series will be presented by one of our awesome community members and a Chef Software alum, Franklin Weber. Frank will lead you through hands-on exercises demonstrating the tools, capabilities, plugins, and resources available to you with InSpec. He'll teach you how to use and write controls, which are the actual tests that define your regulatory concerns, recommendations, and requirements. You'll learn how to bundle controls into an overarching profile used to define a class or set of requirements, such as PCI, SOC 2, or basic patchy hardening, for instance. And within the InSpec shell, you'll learn how to quickly run InSpec controls and tests on the fly. The shell works very similar to Chef Shell, as it allows you to use the InSpec domain-specific language, plugins, and tools available without actually writing a profile or creating any controls. You can also visit learn.chef.io/tracks/try-InSpec to earn some dope badges while learning how to write and use InSpec controls, integrate InSpec into your development pipeline, and view and share compliance results with all the stakeholders in your organization. Until next time, I am Jody Wolfborn, signing off.